Welcome to the ring, fighting tonight out of the blue corner, Ysreal, Prince of God, Barboza.
Welcome back, fight fans, as we are live from San Antonio, Texas. It is Alamo City Fight Night, brought to you by Davies Entertainment. Justin Simmons alongside Casey Ramos as we await the entrance of Ysreal Barboza. Barboza coming in with a 3-0 record. Originally from Victoria, Texas, now fighting out of Corpus Christi. Well, Barboza, his choice of entrance music definitely has some of the crowd on his side. A classic theme that we've heard some of the greats walk out to, especially here in San Antonio. You think of some of the great Mexican fighters that have taken place here: Jesse James Leija, Marcos Antonio Ferreira, Julio Cesar Chavez, and Chavez Jr., just to name a few.
Tons of great fights here in San Antonio, Texas. Tons of great fighters, tons of great trainers. I mean, it's a historic boxing town, and I think we're in for a great night of fights.
I think you can say that it's definitely one of those that's underrated.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, accompanied by special guest and Davies Entertainment recording artist, Bankro, performing Seven Seas. Let's welcome, fighting out of the red corner, Daniel the Beast Baiz!
My name is Daniel Baiz. They call me the Beast. Beasts are fearless. And being from the South Side, you can't have fear. The South Side raised me. The South Side is who I am. I live it. I breathe it. Every time I lace up the gloves. So no matter how high I get in my career, I will always represent where I'm from. I will forever be the South Side.
San Antonio, how y'all doing tonight?
Mosey got that pit for nigga.
I can't hear y'all. San Antonio, how y'all doing? Whoa, 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 whoa.
Crystal Seven Seas, necklace on chili cheese. Yeah, slit like Billy D.
Pop my shit on
Billy D. Yeah,
spent the quarter key.
2-3 stacks on lawyer fee. 4 round me scrap. We don't let we'll beat
you. Grew
up around how it's murder scene. Don't trust nobody, cause I probably robbed somebody. Close to him, come back
Daniel
at 30, let it sing. Yeah, yeah, look, not for real, no space, no cap, no, we don't got no space for that. See my partner bust a booty down, no
I
see my bro, them on the news, and just no way, no saving. We see this ox with the block, and it's popping, buddy. Yeah, nigga, the streets ain't made no joke, no hope, you better be made for that. We gon' do what the who don't read, no foolish niggas ain't great for that. Take your tape and shit, hope my little niggas get paid for that. My little niggas is dog hole killers, and they can't really no change that. Yeah!
The fight fans, and we are ecstatic that you can join us wherever you may be watching.
Follow me on my IG, no space, no count. Davies!
Daniel the Beast Baiz from San Antonio, Texas, South Side. He said that the South Side is who makes him who he is. Well, the South Side also says who makes me who I am.
Well, let's toss it up to Thomas Triver for our official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 6 rounds in the super welterweight division. It is being brought to you by Davies Entertainment in association with Univision, along with their great sponsors, HEB, Carnesazo con Ganas, and the Davis Law Firm. There's only one number to remember, and that's 4. Our 3 judges scoring on a 10-point My system will be Ellis Johnson, Joel Elizondo, and Glenn Crocker. Our referee in charge, third man of the ring, will be John Shorley. Introducing to you first, fighting tonight out of the blue corner, he's wearing black with gold and weighed in at 149 pounds. Undefeated, he has three wins, all three wins come by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, from Corpus Christi, Texas, let's welcome Ysreal Prince of God Barboza. His opponent across the ring fighting tonight out of the red corner. He's wearing black trunks and weighed in at 147 pounds. His professional record, 13 wins, 2 defeats, 5 wins come by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, from right here, San Antonio, Texas, here is Daniel the Beast Baiz.
Chance to talk with Baiz yesterday in the pre-fight interviews. Obviously disappointed in his loss against Marquise Hawthorne on the fight back in August. But he had high hopes for this fight. He's been training very hard. He has said he actually helped build the gym that he does, and his Davies Entertainment stablemates do train in. He takes a lot of pride in what he's been able to do for himself and for his stable. And yeah, we have to start to round one.
Yeah, he should be. He should definitely be proud. There's a lot of great fighters that they have under Davies Entertainment right now. James Kirkland, Daniel Baiz, Eddie the Hunter Ortiz in our main event, and a couple of other up-and-comers. You know, they're looking to make a splash in this town and in a boxing city, and we'll see how they do.
If you can play well here in San Antonio, you should be able to box anywhere, as they usually say. Barboza in the black with gold trim, including the gold waistband. As for Baiz, he is dressed in the black trunks that have the slits on the side with the Davies Entertainment logo in gold on the back.
Yeah, it seems to be no warm up for Baiz. It seems like he's just ready to go. He's letting his hands go. He's not feeling anything out. Barboza seems the one that needs to be a little bit more relaxed, let his hands go. He seems to be doing that right now.
Well, Barboza trying to step in, but Baiz keeps on answering every step with a punch, and it forces Barboza back.
And I believe they fought heavier, about 10 pounds heavier than Baez's last fight, which was at 140.
Yes, both fighters.
So he may be a little bit stronger. He may be a little bit more coherent in terms of being strong and having his stamina going on.
Baiz, the southpaw, Barboza, an orthodox fighter. It is Baiz who has the height advantage as well as the reach, 5'9" to 5'6".
You just saw Barboza try to sneak a counter right hand in there, but it was just one shot. He followed up right there, and it worked for him. It kept Baiz off balance. But you can't just throw one shot, just like Baiz is doing right there, letting his hands go.
It was a good left hook by Barboza that connected on the face of Baiz. And Baiz near the corner right in front of us here at ringside at the Alamodome.
Yeah, Baiz just got caught with a little bit of a left hook right there, stepping straight out with his hands down. And he's also going back in the same direction. He's moving in one direction, he's not stepping in the other. And there he goes, he's changing it.
And we saw a knockdown happen earlier in this card because the fighter just stepped straight back instead of trying to get out of range.
And you see Barboza finding his rhythm a little bit there. He's blocking, making Baiz miss, and then making him pay with the counter hooks.
Baiz trying to answer back here with the right hands and connects with the left uppercut, but eats a shot from the left and the right from Barboza.
Yeah, both guys are here ready to fight. And this is a pretty big step up for Barboza, being only 3-0 and then stepping up to fight a 10-plus win fighter.
Every professional win, a difficult one to gather, especially in the squared circle. Both fighters very tight as they stand into the pocket to end round one. Very even round to start things off in our scheduled 6-round fights.
Yeah, I'd say it's a very close round, but I give the upper hand to Baiz a little bit on that one. He's a little bit more busier. Barboza just seemed to climb up a little bit, not let his hands go too much. And when he did, he was successful. He just threw a little bit more.
And we saw this happen from the blue corner in the last fight with Marquise Hawthorne, but here Barboza not taking a seat either. Let's take a look at the replay really quick.
Down, he didn't have his hands up right there, but he picked him up really quick, as you can see. And I would say that that right hand was probably the defining punch for the round for Baiz in terms of his it being in his favor.
Baiz noting that he has to come out and perform really well in this fight. He has had a round two knockdown in his career. He suffered one in round two, as Baiz, but he's also given one. As for Barboza, he does come in with three KOs. All of his fights haven't extended past round two, and it's now what is his fourth professional fight here tonight.
And Barboza is from a fight town himself in terms in Corpus Christi, a historic fight town. I think you believe that there's a couple of world champs from there. And they have Jerry Belmontes, a former lightweight contender. And we'll see how the connection goes. We'll see what he can do.
I got a chance to talk to Barboza yesterday. He mentioned to me he likes the science of fighting. He's not really showing it here, as both fighters just keep on swinging away at each other. But he takes a lot of his cues from one of the greatest heavyweights ever in Joe Frazier. He's a big fan of Frazier's work.
You did see some of that in the first round. He had his hands up. He had his head moving. He was countering every punch after he blocked it, and it was working for him. So let's see if he can continue that momentum here in the second round.
Going to the body here in round two, and he continues to dig in, this Barboza. Baiz getting backed up here just a little bit as he comes back and answers with a couple of punches of his own.
Barboza is definitely putting in that work right now. He's in the inside. He's got the center of the ring. He's pushing Baiz back. He's letting multiple punches go. He's landing multiple punches. Baiz is throwing back, returning. They're just not as effective.
It looks like Baiz is suffering some swelling on that left cheek after taking another right shot that was hard to the face. But comes back with one, too.
Yeah, that was a beautiful right hand. That's exactly what Baiz needs to do right there. You got the shorter man coming on. He's not giving you any room, but give yourself some room. Throw those straight shots. Get him off you.
It's all about trying to find some breathing room here as Baiz continues to let the right hand flow.
And you see those little short shots getting in for Barboza right there. And he's staying compact. He's staying sharp. He's letting his hands go in combination. Both fighters are currently. Close round. A little bit of momentum in front in terms of Barboza.
Casey, how much damage do those short shots do as opposed to those long-range looping punches?
Well, it just depends on how hard you're throwing them. But short, to me, it's always the short, effective shots that hurt you more than the long-range shots.
Well, both fighters landing those short, effective shots on each other right then and there on that last exchange.
Good body shot right there by Baiz. They're working. Both guys are working right now on the inside. They're not trying to give any inch in terms of the center of the ring. With Barboza, hands up. Good defense, good counter, good combination right there. Let's see what Baiz answers with.
Well, the one thing about Barboza, you have to admit, he doesn't back down. He just keeps on walking forward. But those punches have to accumulate as Baiz continues to swing away on Barboza.
Both guys seems to be trying to go to the body, trying to wear each other down. Barboza's definitely let his hands go. Maybe just a tad bit more than Baiz, and I feel like this round went to Barboza. Let's see how it goes towards the last 10 seconds.
Such a difficult round to score. Counter shots being landed by both fighters. A very entertaining round.
That was an excellent end of the round for Barboza. I'd like to see him sit down. I really like to just see him sit down, let go of the pride, sit down, recover, and come out just as strong on the third round.
He looks to be a little tired. He's crossing his feet as he's leaning against the post. Let's take a look at some of the replay here.
Beautiful 1-2 right there by Baiz. But then you see Barboza with his hands up, getting on the inside, and he's going to land some short shots here momentarily.
And now let's look at this. I think we have some success for Barboza here.
Yeah, another good short left hand, compact, a couple of left hands in a row, and maybe a right hand coming up here shortly.
Now, I am a little concerned because Baiz, he did suffer that cut in his last fight that we saw him. No cuts here, but each fighter getting very close to each other with their heads, and I'm afraid of an accidental headbutt possibly hurting this fight.
That could happen. You know, that could happen. That definitely happens if it's before the fourth round. I believe they call it a no contest. After the fourth round, they go to the scorecards.
Round number three underway. Here from the Alamo Dome, Alamo City Fight Night. Justin Simmons alongside Casey Ramos. Glad that you can be with us wherever you may be watching this particular contest.
I believe Barbosa's definitely in the zone right now. He's feeling good. He's countering. He's doing his best to keep the center of the ring, but Baiz is doing an even better job right now. I believe he's got the momentum in terms of the center of the ring. Barbosa's got the momentum for the fight, and we'll see how it plays out.
Short, compact uppercut by Barboza. Again, lands it on Baiz and knocks him back. And Baiz trying to defend himself as he keeps on backing up away from Barboza. It was a strong right hand that landed as well to the head. And Baiz in a little bit of trouble, but he starts to answer back here as both fighters, they just continue the throw.
Yeah, both guys giving it their all right now. No, not trying to give 1 inch towards the center of the ring. Barbosa's measuring right there and landing cleanly.
Yeah, Barbosa's trying to make this fight a little messy. You keep seeing him paw away at the guard. Baiz forcing his gloves down. Baiz answers back with a straight and another straight hand. The left connects. He has him in a little bit of trouble, but Barboza taking all those punches and staying on his feet and going fist for fist with Baiz. And this crowd is on their feet for this fight.
Action pack. Throwing, guys, is not giving an inch right now.
The Beast, the Prince of God, both exchanging punches, and it's giving us a tremendous show here in San Antonio. Baiz, he is rocked by a shot, another one to the face, and he still stays in the pocket, this Baiz.
This is great matchmaking by Davies Entertainment and the consultant, Keith Underwood. Putting on an awesome show here. Thanks, Keith. Thanks, Davies Entertainment, for such a great night of fights. I mean, it's awesome. It doesn't get no better than these guys are just duking it out, throwing it out.
Just round number three,
skills out of the window.
All the science out the window, like you mentioned, Casey. This is just a pure fight right in the middle of the ring between two top pugilists.
Good body shot by Barboza. Both guys, I'd like to see more than one or two. Go three, four, five, six, and then move your head. And then get, there you go. Look at Barboza. He might have hurt me.
There's a little bit of that Joe Frazier that he's such a fan of. As you saw the beautiful head movement from Barboza. And now Baiz, he's been eating those uppercuts. Those right hands, short but effective from Barboza.
That's exactly what Barboza needs to do. Throw those shots, four, five, six punches, move your head, and then come back with it. Baiz needs to box, use his height, use his jab, use his range.
And that's the end of our action-packed round numero tres here for Alamo City Fight Night.
Baiz is cut.
And we mentioned the cut last time we saw him in Austin, now suffering the cut here in San Antonio, and it seems to be that right eye all over again.
I believe it is, and I don't think it's a head, but I believe that was from a punch. I didn't see any heads collide. We could see the replay. We could see something, but I don't think so. I think that was a clean punch, and I still see Barboza standing up, but I'd like to see him sit down.
Yeah, Barboza refuses to sit down. Let's see what we can spot on the replay if we can find that cut happen anywhere in these exchanges. There were so many punches thrown, Casey. It would be hard to say exactly when it happened.
Beautiful round, beautiful combinations. There's a clean little right, short right hand from Barboza, uppercut, another right hand, and another couple of straight shots from Baiz. I mean, both guys are going at it. Good body shot right there by Baiz right at the end.
For Baiz, it seems that he's had the most success when he has a little bit of range in between him and Barboza. But Barboza has been very quick to smother him throughout this fight as we are here in round number four out of our scheduled six.
As the shorter fighter should, he should be not so much smothering himself or smothering the other fighter, but just getting inside, getting in the range. And he just caught Baiz with a little left hook right there. We'll see how Baiz recovers from that.
Barboza has never gone four professional rounds in his career, but he's really smacking Baiz against the ropes as Baiz is able to fight his way off of those ropes.
Yeah, Baiz is trying to do his best to box and keep the range, but Barboza is not making it easy for him. He seems to be the stronger, fresher fighter right now. He's coming in and he's doing what he wants to do.
Now we see a little distance between both fighters. This is a chance for Baiz to get to work. Really land some of those jabs if he can.
Hey, that's what Baiz needs to do. But even then, you saw the range was there, and Barboza got the better of the exchange on the counter.
Yeah, and that was with that right hand counter as well. And again, a shot to the body with the uppercut with the right hand. Baiz trying to answer back here as he now goes with some combinations. Exactly what he needed.
Baiz staying busy right now. I have a slight edge for Baiz.
And again, Baiz has that cut over the right eye. It hasn't hindered him here, but last time he had a cut, he went down in the next round.
That was a nice, sneaky body shot by Barboza right there.
Oh, and Baiz slips.
Baiz had the momentum in his favor. It seems to be shifting just slightly right now for Barboza. We'll see if he can hold on to it.
That jumping uppercut lands flush on the chin, and both fighters again just locking gloves, standing in the pocket, head to head, fist to fist, and just letting it all fly here in round number four.
Excellent round for both guys. Both guys giving it their all, staying in the pocket. Barboza just seems to have a little bit of a better defense, and he has a better counterattack going on right now.
Casey, I just have to say, I'm so glad we are not getting paid to have to judge this fight, because it is so difficult to tell the difference between both two. Each of them have had their positives, each have had their negatives, but they are giving us one hell of a fight.
Very, very good fight. Very excellent pugilistic skills. You know, guys giving it their all, guys putting all their training and all their hard work to show right now.
And despite taking those hard shots, Baiz seems to stay calm, and he answers back with a right and a left of his own. And those are the punches and bunches that he needs. And he connects here in round four, does Baiz.
Very close round.
But Barboza, he is like a machine, not wearing down. He continues just to smother Baiz and landing those short and effective shots. And here comes Baiz. Another close round. I don't know how the guys have the stamina here. This crowd is electric, and rightfully so. Both of these combatants giving us everything they have, and it is making for an electric night here in the Alamo City.
Two rounds left. We'll see what both guys got. And you can see Barboza, he's feeling it now. He wish he would have sat out of those front of early rounds. And I'm telling you, I wish he would have too. It could be the difference in the fight, especially a fight this close, a fight this strategic, a fight this gruesome. You know, it's grueling, it's baggage, so it's a war of tactics.
Well, we have some of the replays rolling here, but that's a great point. Fresh legs would make such a big difference for Barboza in this fight, but he still refuses to sit down. Is that just a psychological game, Casey?
It's gotta be psychological. You can saw as soon as he got back to the corner, he took a knee, he bent down, he squatted his legs like he wanted to sit down. And you know, if you want to sit down, just sit down. You're in a fight. You're not in training. You're not sparring. All the hard work is done. Just save yourself and get ready for the last two rounds.
Does that come from the trainer, or does that come from the boxer's preference?
You know, that comes from both, I think. I think the trainer can say anything he wants to, but ultimately the fighter's the one in there, and he can make the call.
Well, like you told me before, when you're in there, you're rolling one deep. Only you can fight for yourself.
That's it.
And we're here in round number five in what has been one tenacious fight between these two pugilistic artists. Baiz lands a hard right to the right side of the temple.
Yeah, beautiful right hand. He just needs to follow up a little bit. He seems to be recovered from that last round a little bit better than Barboza, but we'll see how these last two rounds play out.
And I'm wondering if that's because he decided to sit down.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. It's you know, that could have been the edge in the fight. I mean, it's a psychological ploy or whatever it is. You think you're in shape, that you've trained, but at the same time, you know, that's not gonna take away from how hard you're trying in that fight.
Barboza in his pro career has never gone past round two, and he's rocked. Can Baiz finish him off here after he has Barboza on some wobbly legs? And it looks like Barboza recovered quickly.
Barboza recovered very quickly. He was stunned, no doubt. His legs wobbled. He fell forward a little bit, but the killer instinct in him kicked in. He decided to cover up and start to return right away.
These two fighters connected right in the middle of the ring as they exchange once again. Receipts being taken by both fighters. And this has the crowd on their feet here in the Alamo Dome in the Alamo City.
Awesome fight. Both guys returning fire, just letting it all out, leaving it all in the ring.
I hope you fans at home on Univision are enjoying it as much as everyone here at ringside. It has been a great fight thus far between Baiz and Barboza. Barboza hurt a little bit as he backs up away from Baiz. And now trying to charge him forward, and Baiz just making him eat right after left after right.
Baiz feeling it now, feeling himself, letting those short shots go. Barboza may be catching a second win here. He's letting it all out. He's pressing the fight. He's not letting the crowd take the fight out of his hands. He's trying to show the judges he still got it. And he's pushing forward.
Barboza just stalking his prey, continues to stay close to Baiz. And now Baiz hooks him around the guard with both the left and the right.
Beautiful move right there by Baiz. Took his back off the ropes, turned around, and put Barboza right back on the ropes.
Yeah, great technique by Baiz to get his back off the ropes. And you see him using all the angles as he continues to walk around Barboza, who is plodding towards him for it.
Very good round, very excellent round for Baiz. Comeback round for sure.
How do you score this fight, Casey? I don't have a clue because both fighters seem so close, and now the stool comes out. It looks like Barboza is finally going to have a seat.
That's what I was hoping for. Come on, man. It's the last
round. He's still
not
sitting down.
It's the last round. Just take a seat. Take a seat. Recover. Breathe deep. Let the pride go. And just keep your head in the fight. I mean, he's in there. But that's what it's going to take. It's going to take every little bit for this last round.
The stool is in there, but he refuses to sit. Baiz is finding a great fight. As you see, both fighters have been wobbly in the last couple of rounds. But they've both been quick to recover. And they just keep on trading blows.
Yeah, as you see right there, Baiz just letting the short shots go, short, straight punches. There wasn't any too much on them, but they were accurate.
That
they landed.
Beautiful.
And there he goes, just feeling it, letting his hands go, what he should have been doing the whole fight. And what he actually has been doing the whole fight. It's just, you know, he has got a tough opponent in front of him.
Fight fans, let's cheer these two combatants on.
Like
this is
the
sixth
and
final round.
Each time they get closer to each other, they stick right at each other, right in the center of the ring, and that's how they will begin the sixth and final round in what has been such a spectacular fight.
You're right, Barboza barely wanted to even touch hands. He touched hands for a second, went right back to work, put his head down, put his hands up, and went right back to work, started throwing those hands.
Baiz able to back up Barboza, who showed him his back for a split second. The right hand landed on the body from Baiz, but the right straight from Barboza hit Baiz right on the chin.
I still have Barboza slightly ahead. Baiz won the last couple of rounds, and I believe this last round is the deciding factor for either fighter.
Barboza has never gone to round six. Baiz has gone to round six once in his career, and he lost on a decision to Kenton Sippo Cook back in 2016.
And I was there, Ken Scipio Cook, a fellow stable mate of mine from Austin, Texas, at a Richard Lord's boxing gym. That was right there in Austin, Texas, at a South by Southwest show, I believe. And they were both undefeated fighters fighting for a title, and Ken Scipio Cook came out on top.
And Scipio Cook, he has some good moves, and a little too much for Baiz on that particular evening. But let's see what Baiz has here. He's coming off of that TKO loss. He's really fought well here tonight against a tough opponent, and Barboza has answered each and every call as well.
Yeah, Barboza, he's got a lot to be proud of coming in here 3-0, fighting a 10-plus win veteran in Baiz. And, you know, there's nothing, like I said, there's nothing to be ashamed of. Just he did an excellent job tonight, kept his hands up, kept his defense up, let his hands go, and put up a great fight in front of a hostile crowd.
15 fights, 53 rounds for Baiz. Just three fights, four rounds career-wise for Barboza as we're past the midway point here in the sixth and final round.
I give the first half to Barboza. Seems like the second half may be shifting to Baiz. Let's see who can finish out stronger. Last minute.
Last punch was a counter shot landed by Barboza with the short left. Hits with the lead right to the jaw for Barboza.
Yeah, both guys are trying to be tactical now. They don't have too much energy in the reserves right now. They're trying to be as tactical as they can, be as wise as they can with the energy, let their hands go at the right time and land something big.
And they will both scrap once again. Barboza backs up a little bit as Baiz trying to walk down the smaller opponent, and Baiz connects with a couple of looping hooks. The crowd really behind both fighters. It was a straight left hand thrown and landed by Baiz. getting to our final 10 seconds here in this sixth and final round. What a fight here at Alamo City Fight Night.
Both guys extremely fatigued. Great fight. You see the respect? I mean, they gave it the all.
I have no clue, Casey, who did enough to sway the judges' vote for the win here tonight. I would hate to see this go to a draw, but it's very possible, as both fighters were very even throughout this bout.
Very, very possible to be having a draw. Very good matchmaking again by Keith Underwood, a local consultant from Underwood Promotions, working for Davies Entertainment tonight. And I mean, they put on a heck of a show so far. Both great matches with Marquise Hawthorne and Carlos Villa. Now here, another great one with Barboza and Baiz.
Back-to-back fights where it was hard to sit down because they were both so action-packed. It's so far been a great evening here in San Antonio from the Alamodome. We are glad that you can be with us on Univision, alongside myself, Justin Simmons, and Casey Ramos. So much fun here at ringside, especially when we get high-quality fights like this. And you see that little cut on Baiz, again, above that right eye, like you mentioned before. This time, it didn't affect him.
I was just going to say, shout-out to the cut man in Baez's corner. After that cut, you didn't even notice it. You noticed no blood virtually coming off his eye. I mean, it didn't bother him. It didn't seem to show any effects towards his game plan. He kept throwing the shots. The fight seemed to intensify even after that.
You see both fighters showing much respect. It was a great fight between these two, but hopefully we will have a winner after this battle. Let's toss it up to Thomas Triver for our official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after six rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Joel Elizondo scores it 58-56 in favor of Daniel Baiz. And both judges Ellis Johnson and Glenn Crocker score it the same 57-57. This bout is a majority draw.
Just talked about that, Casey, the possibilities of this going to a draw. Baiz did enough to sway one of the judges, but the other two judges, and I can't fault him for this, seeing it very, extremely even.
Know, same. Very difficult rounds to call. You know, I guess the only good thing we can take out of it is that both guys gave their all and they didn't come out with a loss. Yeah, I know both guys would have much rather have had the win. But again, you know, neither guy lost. Both guys gave it their all. Both guys walked out with their health. And at the end of the day, that's pretty much all you can ask for in this game.
Yeah, that's all you can really ask for is that it was scored fairly. I don't think anybody will have any complaints. And we'll go to Paco with the post-fight interview.
Thank you, guys. Well, Daniel, draw. Is that what you expected?
I ain't worried about it. It was a good fucking fight. That's what everyone came to see. What's up, Southside? Where you at? KC. Where's Cruising Kitchens? What up?
That was a great fight, man. You took some heavy punches. Was that what you were in the first round? What did you improve after that first round?
I just tried to adjust. He's a fucking strong motherfucker. He's short, too, so what made it, he was a real compact fighter. So it was pretty different. It was hard.
What's next for Daniel?
I don't know. You don't tell me, you tell my boss. You tell my superiors, they let you know.
Get back. Baby J, we're going to go back to you.